the street. I don't want anyone should see it. I've been walking so good.
What gripe? You know how many guys have picked a gimp leg for sympathy? A bum leg of yours is a gold mine.
Someone gets the idea I can't make it on my own. They'll lock me up in the refuge for good. Be a pal, Jack. Help me down. Woo!
You want to bust your other leg too?
No. I want to go down.
You'll be down there soon enough. Take a moment to drink in my penthouse high above the stinking streets of New York.
You're crazy.
Because I like a breath of fresh air. Because I like seeing the sky and the stars.
Seeing stars, all right.
The streets down there, they suck the life right out of my old man. Years of rotten jobs being stomped on by bosses. And when they finally broke him, they tossed him to the curb like yesterday's paper. Well, they ain't doing that to me.
But everyone wants to come here.
New York's fine for those who can afford a big, strong door to lock it out. But I tell you, Crutchy, there's a whole other way out there. So you keep your big life in a small city, your big life in a small town. They say folks is dying to get here. Me, I'm dying to get away to a little town out west that's spanking new. And while I ain't ever been there, I can see it clear as day. If you want, I bet you you could see it too. Close your eyes, come with me, where it's clean and green and pretty. And they went and made a city out of clay. Why, the minute that you get there, folks will walk right up and say, welcome home, son, welcome home to Santa Fe. Planting crops, splitting rails, swapping sails around the fire, set for Sunday when you lie around all day. Soon your friends is more like family, and they's begging you to stay. Got no folks nowhere. You?
I don't need folks. I got friends.
Hey, how's about you come with me? No one cares about no gimp leg in Santa Fe. You just hop a Palomino. You're riding style.
Hey, Jimmy. Riding in style?
Hey, I bet a few months of clean air. Huh? You can toss that crutch for good.
Try and make a bomb for Mama. Doctor
in the nuts. Oh, could it be?
Let the lands he brought us.
Hey, Oscar. Word on the street says you and your brother took money to beat up struggling trolley workers.
So, it's honest work?
The cracking heads of defenseless workers?
I take care of the guy who takes care of me.
Hey, ain't your father one of the strikers?
I guess he didn't take care of me.
It's not nice, Morris.
But what, Jack Skunk's?
Yeah, unfortunate day, but fine, you got yourself a bunk out of your own. How would you like us picking on you? Maybe we should, find out?
Yeah!
Pulitzer ever gave her circulation to the data since the war ended.
Whoever said war is hell wasn't trying to sell newspapers.
We could use an exciting headline.
What have we got today?
The trolley strike.
That's not exciting. It's epic.
It's boring. Folks want to know, is the trolley coming or ain't it? No one cares why.
And the strike's about to be settled. Governor Roosevelt just put the support behind the workers.
That man is a socialist.
Teddy Roosevelt is no socialist. He's an American hero.
The man must have a football for being too violent. Football. Violent. You're right. He's no socialist. He's a commie. Gentlemen, you're making Nuncio nervous. And when Nuncio gets nervous, I don't look pretty.
He never liked Roosevelt. You read an editorial against him day after day when he ran for governor. And guess what? He got elected.
How am I supposed to influence voters if they're not reading my opinion?
Big photos attract readers.
Do you know what big photos cost?
But without flashy photos or headlines, how are we supposed to sell more papers?
There's an answer right before your eyes. You're not thinking this through. People! Nuncio knows when he's cutting my hair. Trim a bit here and then trim a bit there. Just a modest adjustment, in fact, to the bottom line. Shaving is tricky, the razor should float. Trim it too close and you may cut my throat. It's the simplest solutions that boils to the bottom line.
I've got it! Right now, we charge the newsies 50 cents per 100 papers.
Yes?
But what if we increase their prices to 60 cents per 100?
Now you're getting somewhere.
It's a mere tenth of a penny per paper?
Every single newsie would have to sell 25 more papers just to earn the same amount as always.
My thought exactly. It's genius.
It's gonna be awfully rough on those children.
Nonsense. I'm giving them a real-life lesson in economics. I couldn't offer them a better education if they were my own. Give me a week and I'll train them to be like an army that's marching to war. They're proud of themselves and so grateful to me. They'll be begging to pay them more. But there's still a ton of shoes, boys, for God's sake, relax. Quiet them out, all we need is some wax. Listen well to these barbershop lessons, for they'll see you through. In the morning. Just a few comments.
Dad tends with a delivery truck on the job.
messed up his leg bad, so they laid him off. That's how come we had to find work.
No, that makes sense. Too bad about your dad.
Hey, why don't you come home with us for dinner? Our folks would be happy to have you.
Mom's a great cook.
Thanks for the invite. I just remembered I got plans with a fella. He's probably waiting on me now.
Is that the guy you mean? Kelly!
Run for it!
Grab him! You! Jack Kelly! Stop! Kelly!
Someone want to tell me why I'm running? I got no one chasing me. Who was that guy?
The Snyder. The Spider. Real sweetie. There's a jail for our nerds kids called the Refuge. The more kids he locks up, the more money the city pays him. Only problem is that money goes straight into his own pocket. Do yourselves a favor and stay clear of him and the Refuge.
Hey, you up there? Shoot! No kids allowed in the theater!
Not even me, Miss Meadow!
Jack Kelly, Man of Mystery! Keeping yourself, kid?
Never far from you, Miss Meta. Boys, may I introduce Miss Meta Larkin, greatest star in the Bowery today. Also owns the joint.
The only thing I own is the mortgage. Pleasure, gents.
A pleasure. What's wrong with you?
Are you blind? They've got no clothes on.
That's their costume.
But I can see their legs.
Step out of her way so she can get a better look. Theater's not only entertaining. It's educational. Got the picture, kid?
Miss Meta, I got a little situation on the street. Mind if I had it here a while?
We're better to escape trouble than a theater. Is Snyder after you again?
Hey, Jack, did you really escape jail in the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage?
What would the governor be doing in a juvenile jail?
Just so happens he was running for office and wanted to show we didn't care about orphans and such. So he got his mug in the paper. I got my butt in the back seat. My friend wrote to get it.
You really know the governor?
He don't, but I do. Say, Jack, when you've got time, I want you to paint me some more of those backdrops. This last one you did is a doozy. Folks love it, and things have been going so well that I can actually pay.
I can take your money, Miss Meta.
You pictured that?
Your friend is quite an artist.
And don't get carried away. It's a bunch of trees.
You're really good.
That boy's got natural aptitude.
Gee, I never knew nobody with aptitude.
Mr. Meta! You're on!
Yeah? How am I doing? Boys, lock the door and stay all night. You're with Meta now.
Ladies!
Myself, folks.
reviewing the show for the New York Sun.
Hey, I work for the world.
Somewhere out there, someone cares. Go tell them.
The view's better here.
Please go. I'm not in the habit of speaking to strangers.
You're gonna make a lousy reporter. The name is Jack Kelly.
Is that what it says in your rap sheets?
Oh, a smile girl. I admire smile girls. Beautiful, smart, independence.
Do you mind? You got in for free. At least pay attention.
Sorry, madam. I got no use for moonlight or sappy poetry. At first sight's for suckers, at least it used to be. Look, girls are nice, once or twice, till I find someone new. But I never planned on no one like you.
Don't come and knock me on my door. You aren't welcome here no more. I should have to know you so.
Hey! Stop
Hey, Jack, you still thinking? Well, sure he is. Can't you smell the smoke?
All right, here's the deal. If we don't sell papes, no one sells papes. No one gets to that window until they put the price back where it belongs.
You mean like a strike?
You are a Dave, you are a strike! Yeah! They shut down this place like the Morgan shut down the trolleys.
And the cops will bust our heads. Half them strikers was laid up with broke bones.
Cops ain't gonna care about a bunch of kids. Right, Davey?
Leave me out of this. I'm just here trying to feed my family.
What? One of the rest of us is our playtime? Just because we all make pennies don't give nobody the right to rub our noses in it.
It doesn't matter. You can't strike. You're not a union.
And what if I says we
is? Well, there's a lot of things you gotta have in order to be a union. Like membership.
What do you call these guys?
Officers?
I nominate Jack President! Yeah!
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
How about a statement of purpose?
Must have left it in my other pants.
What's a statement of purpose?
A reason for forming the union.
What reason did them trolley workers have?
I don't know. Wages? Work hours? Safety on the job?
We don't need that. But if your father had a union, you wouldn't be out here selling papers right now, yeah?
Yeah.
So our union is hereby formed to watch over each other's backs! Union we stand! Yeah! Okay, that's not bad. Someone write that down.
I got a pencil.
Me have Secretary of State!
Strike, the membership's gotta vote.
So let's vote. What do you say, fellas? The choice is yours. Do you let Pulitzer roll us over and pick our pockets? Or do we strike? Yeah, you heard the voice of the membership. The newsies of Lower Manhattan are now officially on strike. So what's next?
Wouldn't a strike be more effective if someone in charge knew about it?
Yeah, it'd be a pleasure to tell Weasel myself.
Yeah, and who tells Pulitzer? Davey?
I don't know. I guess you do, Mr. President.
And what are we telling?
The newspaper owners need to respect your rights as employees.
Pulitzer and Hearst gotta respect the rights of the working kids of this city!
They can't just change the rules when they feel like it.
That's right! We do the work so we get a say!
Yeah!
We've got a union!
Yeah!
All of your headlines will be making on today. And now, who's the big spender on ordered seltzer?
Over here.
That'll be 2 cents.
2 cents for a glass of seltzer? Just give me water.
How did I ever see that coming?
Well, I'd say we launched our strike in a most auspicious manner.
Well, I don't know about that, but we just get the bejesus out of Weasel!
Yeah! Now we gotta spread the word. Let the rest of the city's newsies know about the strike.
You're right, the man. Let's split up and spread the word.
I'll take Harlem. Yeah, I got Midtown. I got the Bronx. Oh, I got the Bowery.
Specs, you take Queens. Tommy Boy, you take the East Side. And who else? Brooklyn. Come on, Brooklyn. Spock Harlan's turf.
Finch, you telling me you're scared of Brooklyn?
I ain't scared of no turf. But that Spock Harlan gets me a little jittery.
Davey and I can take Brooklyn.
Me, I have to.
Why is everyone so scared of Brooklyn?
What are you doing here?
Asking a question. Have you got an answer?
Brooklyn is the 6th largest city in the world. You got Brooklyn, you hit the motherload. Say, for someone who works at the Sun, you spend an awful lot of time hanging around at the word. So what's that about, huh?
You following me?
The only thing I'm following is a story. A ragtag gang of ragamuffins wants to take on the kingmakers of New York. Think you've got a chance?
Shouldn't you be at the ballet?
Question too difficult? I'll reach brains. Will the richest and most powerful men in New York give the time of day to a gang of kids who haven't got a nickel to their name?
Hey!
Oh, hey! You don't gotta be insulting!
I got a nickel.
So, I guess you'd say you're a couple of Davids looking to take on Goliath.
We never said that.
You didn't have to. I did.
Seen a lot of papes in my day, and I ain't never doing no girl reporter writing hard news.
Wake up to the new century. The game's changing. How about an exclusive interview?
Can't you be entertainment?
This is entertaining? So far?
What's the last news story you wrote?
What's the last strike you organized?
Oh! Not your way, Kelly. You think the ladies be on a buyout? Real man.
You think strong, Romeo.
How'd you know my name?
I'd say we save any exclusive for a real reporter.
You see somebody else giving you the time of day? All right, so I'm just busting out of the social pages, but you give me the exclusive, let me run with the story, and I promise, I'll get you the space.
You really think we could be in the papers?
Shut down a paper like The World, and you're gonna make the front page.
All right, you want a story? Get the circulation gates tomorrow morning and you'll get one. And bring a camera. You're gonna want to snap a picture of this!
Yeah!
All right, boys, play outside. I gotta set up for dinner. I got paying customers that need the tables.
Come on! We got news in the building!
We're gonna be shooting this up when we get our mugs in the paper.
Mr. Kelly!
Today we stop our city's newsies from carrying no papes. But the wagons still deliver to the rest of the city. Tomorrow we stop the wagons.
Are you scared?
Do I look scared? But ask me again in the morning.
Good answer. Good night, Mr. Kelly.
Wait, where are you going? It ain't supper time.
I'll see you in the morning. And off the record, good luck.
Hey, Plumber. Write it good. You both got a lot riding on you.
You heard the man. Write it good. Write it good or it's back to wheezing your way through the flower show. No pressure. Let's go. Newsies, stop the world. A little hyperbole never hurt anyone. With all eyes fixed on the trolley strike, there's another battle brewing in the city. And if I could just write about it. Come on, Captain, those boys are counting on you. Write what you know, so they say. All I know is I don't know what to write or the right way to write it. This is big lady, don't screw it up. This is nothing, let a vaudeville on radio. Poor little kids versus rich, greedy sourpusses. It's a cinch, it could practically write itself. Let's pray it does. Design may have mentioned, I have no clue what I'm doing. Am I insane? This is what I've been waiting for. Well, that plus a screaming of 10 angry editors. A girl, it's a girl. How the hell is that even legal? Look, just go and get her. Not only that, there's a story behind the story. Thousands of children exploited, invisible. Speak up, take a stand, and there's someone to write about it. That's how things get better. Give life's little guy some ink, and when it dries, just watch what happens. Those kids will live and breathe right on the page, and when
wasn't he?
I'd say.
So are they with us?
Well, it all depends on how you look at it.
If you look and see Brooklyn, then they're with us.
They want to prove that we're not going to fool them the first time in trouble.
Are we?
We are not! There's us in Harlem.
Not so fast, boss. Harlem wants to know what Brooklyn's going to do.
How about Queens?
Queens will be right there backing us up.
You see?
As soon as they get the nod from Brooklyn.
I got the same fisheye in Midtown.
Say, Oscar, looks like we got some bum information about the strike happening here today. Not that I'm complaining. My skull busting arm could use a day of rest.
Are we doing the right thing?
Sure we are.
Well, maybe we put this off a couple of days.
No, we can't. Say something. Tell them if we back off now, they will never listen to us again.
No, we can't back down now. No matter who does or doesn't show, like it or not. Now is when we take a stand!
How about we just don't show up for work? That'll send a message!
They'll just replace us! We need to see us stand our ground. Come on, Davey, tell them!
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Minute by minute, that's how you win it.
Any signs of reinforcements? Baby?
Courage cannot erase our fear. Courage is when we face our fear. Tell those in power, safe in their tower, we will not obey.
Now it's time to seize the day.
Now it's time to seize the day.
got a headline. Uzi's crush, a close attack. Crunchy's calling me dumb. Crips just too damn slow. Guys are fighting, bleeding, falling. Thanks to good old Captain Jack. Captain Jack just wants to close his eyes and glow. Let me go.
Long enough to drink in the moment?
you're famous, the world is your oyster.
Your what?
Your oyster. Your oyster? Your oyster. Your fancy clam with a pearl inside.
Tomorrow they may wrap fishes in it, but I'm just a poor one.
How are you? I'm okay. Guess I wasn't much help yesterday. Snyder soaked me real good with my crutch. Oh, yeah, Jack. This is Crutchy, by the way. He's here, guards. They is rude. They say jump. Will you jump or you're screwed? But the food ain't so bad.
Santa Fe? Hey, you seen the paper? We're front page news. Above the fold. Oh, yes, above the fold.
Good for you.
Everyone wants to meet the famous Jack Kelly. Even Spot Collins sent a kid just to let us know. Next event, you can count on them. How's about that?
We got stomped into the ground.
Sure, they got us this time, but we took round one. And with press like this, our fight is far from over.
Every newsie who could walk showed up this morning to sell papers like this strike never happened.
And I was there with them. If I don't sell papers, my folks don't eat.
Save your breath. You get it, it's hopeless.
But then I saw the look on Weasel's face. He was actually nervous. And I realized this isn't over. We got him worried. Really worried. And I walked away. A lot of other kids did too, and that is what you call a beginning.
There he is! Just like I said he'd be.
Crying out loud, what's a guy gotta do to get away from you people?
There's no escaping us, pal. We're inevitable.
So, what's the story? Will Mena let us have the theater?
Pipe down, I didn't ask yet.
Well, what's the holdup? I gotta let my guy know if we've got a date.
Your guy?
You heard me. I've been swatting folks away all morning.
Bane is one intoxicated potion. And this here by Sal, he's a plum.
Point is, you wrote a great story.
You look like hell.
Hey, Jack, where's that supposed to be?
It's Santa Fe.
I have to tell you, Jack, this Go West young man routine is getting tired. Even Horace Greeley moved back to New York.
Yes, he did. And then he died.
Your report is supposed to be nonpartisan.
Ask a reporter. Pulitzer's had me blacklisted from every news desk in town.
Can we table the palaver and get back to business? Will Meadow let us have the theater?
That's what I've been trying to tell you. We want to hold a rally, a whole citywide meeting where every newsie gets a say in a vote. And we do it after working hours so no one loses a day's pay. Smart?
Smart enough to get you committed to a padded room.
The guy who paints places he's never seen is calling us crazy?
Want to see a place I've seen? How about this? Newsy Square. Filled to overflowing with failure thanks to my big mouth. Dozens hurt, others arrested.
Like now, no one died.
Oh! Is that what you're aiming for? Well, go ahead, call me a quitter, call me a coward. There's no way I'm putting them kids back in danger.
We're doing something no one's ever done before. How can that not be dangerous?
Specs brought me a note from Crutchy at the refuge. I tried to see him. Climbed up the fire escape. But they busted him up so bad he couldn't even come to the window. You know, what if he don't make it? Are you willing to shoulder that for a tenth of a penny, a penny?
It's not about pennies. You said it yourself. My family wouldn't be in the mess we're in if my father had a union. This is a fight we have to win.
If I wanted a sermon, I'd show up for church.
Tell me how Quinn does Crutchy any good. Exactly. So, here's how it goes. Once we win, and we will be winning, make no mistake.
We what?
We're already winning.
Right.
And we tell them straight out, they let Crutchy go and they keep getting pounded.
Dave, what the hell? Did they bust up your brains or something? As I recall, that we all got our asses kicked. They won.
Won the battle.
Oh, come on.
Jackie, think about it. We got them surrounded.
Here's what I think. Joe's a jerk. He's a rattlesnake.
Right. Know why Snake starts to rattle?
No, why?
Cause he's scared.
Shut up.
Go and look it up. The poor guy's head is spinning. Why did he send for the goons? An entire army, dozens of goons, and the cops. And
I know you may be right.
Thank you, God.
Mr. Mayor, would the fact that this rally is being organized by an escaped convict be enough to shut it down?
Escaped convict?
A fugitive from one of your own institutions. A convicted thief at large wreaking mischief on our law-abiding community. Mr. Snyder, which one is he?
That one there. Jack Kelly.
And how do you know this boy?
His is not a
pleasant story. He was first sentenced to my refuge for loitering and vagrancy, but his total disregard of authority has made him a frequent visitor.
He called him a thief and escaped caught.
After his release, I caught him myself, red-handed, trafficking stolen food and clothing. He was last sentenced to 6 months, but the willful ruffian escaped.
So you'd be doing the city a service by removing this criminal from our streets?
If that's the case, we could take him in quietly.
What good would quiet do me? I want a public example made of him.
Mr. Pulitzer, the boy, Jack Kelly, is here.
Here?
Just outside. He's asked to see you.
Ask and he shall be received. Mr. Snyder, if you please, sit. Catherine.
Mr. Jack Kelly.
Morning, gents.
And which Jack Kelly is this? The charismatic union organizer, or the petty thief and escaped convict?
Which one gives us more in common, huh?
Impudence is a bad taste for crawling for mercy.
Crawling? That's a laugh. No, I just dropped out with an invite. Seems a few hundred of your employees are rallying to discuss recent disagreements. I thought it only fair to invite you to state the case straight to the fellas. So what do you say, Joe? Why should I say you are swallowing the bill?
You are as shameless and disrespectful a creature as I was told. Do you know what I was doing when I was your age, boy? I was fighting in a war.
Yeah? How'd that turn out for you?
It taught me a lesson that shaped my life. You don't win a war on the battlefield. It's the headline that crowns the victor.
Well, keep that in mind when New York wakes up to front page photos of our rally.
Rally till the cows come home. Not a paper in town will publish a word. And if it's not in the paper, it never happened.
You may run this town, but there are some people who can't be bullied, even some reporters.
Such as that young woman who made you yesterday's news. Talented girl, and beautiful as well, don't you think?
Delia said so.
No need, she can hear for herself. Can't you, darling? I trust you know my daughter, Catherine. Yes, my daughter. Now you are probably wondering, why the nom de plume? Why doesn't my daughter work for me? Good questions. I offered Catherine a life of wealth and leisure. Instead, she chose to pursue a career. And she was showing real promise until this recent lapse. But you're all done with that now, aren't you, sweetheart?
Jack, I...
Don't worry the boy with your problems, dearest. Mr. Kelly has a place full of his own. Wouldn't you say so, Mr. Snyder?
Hello, Jack.
Oh! Does anyone else feel a noose tightening? But allow me to offer an alternate scenario. You attend this rally and you speak against this hopeless strike. I'll see your criminal record expunged, and your pockets filled with enough cash to carry you in a first-class train compartment from New York to New Mexico and beyond. You did say you wanted to travel west, didn't you?
There ain't a person in this room who don't know you stick.
And if they know me, they know I don't care. Mark my word, boy. Defy me, and I will have you and every one of your friends locked up in the refuge. Now, I know you're Mr. Tough Guy, but it wouldn't be right to condemn that little crippled boy to conditions like those. And what about your pal Davy and his little sister, ripped from their loving family and tossed to the rats? Would they ever be able to thank you enough? Time's running out, kid, so what do you say? Cowboy or convict, I win either way. Your abject surrender was always the bottom line. Gentlemen, escort our guest to the cellar so he might reflect in solitude. Too bad you've no job, Jack, but you'd agree. Glad you know family, but you can't have mine. Be glad you're alive, boy, and say that's the bottom line.
So that's the fight for your new what to play.
Till those kids all believed you were right.
Lucky for them, all the them go away.
They may not be so lucky tonight.
brass knuckles.
You can sleep right here, right on this old printing press. Now that there is farm.
Oh,
speech you made.
How'd you get here?
Spec showed me.
Did he say you can go through my stuff?
I saw them rolled up sticking out of there. I didn't know what they were. These drawings. These are drawings of the refuge, aren't they? Is this really what it's like in there? Three boys to a bed, rats everywhere, and vermin?
Well, all different from what you were raised.
Snyder told my father you arrested stealing food and clothing. This is why, isn't it? You stole to feed those boys. I don't understand. If you were willing to go to jail for those boys, how could you turn your back on them now?
I don't think anyone would talk about turning on folks.
I never turned on you or anyone else.
No, you just double-crossed us to your father. Your father!
My father has eyes in every corner of this city. He doesn't need me spying for him. And I never lied. I didn't tell you everything.
Well, if you weren't a girl, you'd be trying to talk with a fist in your mouth.
I told you I worked for the Sun, and I did. I told you my professional name was Plumber, and it is. You never asked my real one.
Well, I wouldn't think I had to unless I knew I was dealing with a bastard.
And if I was a boy, you'd be looking at me through one swan eye.
Don't let that stop you. Give me your best shot.
Woo!
I need to know you didn't cave for the money.
You spoke the truth. In the fight when you got the other fella down in the pavement. I didn't know what else we could do. You heard your father. No matter how many days we strike, he'd never give it up.
I know what we can do.
Oh, come on.
Really, Jack? Really? Only you can have a good idea? Or is it because I'm a girl?
I didn't say
that. This would be a good time to shut up. Being boss doesn't mean you have all the answers. Just the brains to recognize the right one when you hear it.
I'm listening.
Good for you! The strike was your idea, the rally was Davies, and now my plan will bring us to the finish line. Deal with it.
Children's crusade?
For the sake of all the kids in every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse in New York, I beg you, join us. With those words, the strike stopped just being about the newsies. You challenge our whole generation to stand up and demand a place at the table.
The Children's Crusade!
Think, Jack, if we publish this, my words with one of your drawings. And if every worker under 21 read it and stayed home from work, or better yet, came to Newsy Square, a general citywide strike. Even my father couldn't ignore that.
Only one small problem, we got no way to print it.
Come on, there has to be one printing press he doesn't control.
Oh no.
What?
I know with this one printing press knowing everything we use.
Then why are we still standing here?
Wait, hold on. What's this about? I'm not talking about the Children's Crusade. What's this about? Am I kidding myself? Was there something?
Of course there is.
Well, don't just say it like it happens every day. No! I'm not an idiot. You know, girls like you don't wind up with guys like me. You don't want you promising nothing you're gonna regret later. I'm standing here tonight, looking at you. Scared tomorrow's gonna come and change everything. If there was a way I could grab hold of something just so I could make time stop. Just so as I could keep looking at you.
You snuck up on me, Jack Kelly. I never even saw it coming.
For sure?
For sure. Till the moment I found you, I thought I knew what love was. Now I'm learning what is true.
Forever.
father wasn't after my head.
You're not really scared of my father.
No, but I'm pretty scared of you.
Don't be!
And if I'm gone tomorrow,
guys sweating blood in the shops for the boss.
money back guarantee.
And thanks for your lessons on the power of the press.
Did you read this, boss? These kids actually put out a pretty good paper. It's very convincing.
No doubt written by my daughter.
I'd sign it before someone else grabs her.
I demand to know who defied my ban on printing strike material.
We are loyal employees. We'd never take our business elsewhere.
That old printing press in the cellar.
I made you the offer of a lifetime. Anyone who does not act in his own self-interest is a fool.
So what's that make you? This all began because you want to sell more papers, but now your circulation is down 70%. Why didn't you just come talk to us?
These guys like Joe don't talk with nothings like us.
But a very wise reporter once told me that a real boss don't need all the answers. Just the smarts to snatch the right one when he hears it.
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Minute by minute, that's how you win it. We will find a way. But let us seize the day.
Have a look out there, Mr. Pulitzer. In case you ain't figured it out, we got you surrounded.
New York is closed for business. Paralyzed. Can't send a message, or get a paper, or get a shoe shine. You can't cross the Brooklyn Bridge. You can't even leave your own building. So what's your next move?
Pulitzer, the mayor is here, along with your daughter. And oh, you're not gonna believe who else?
Good morning, Mr. Pulitzer. I think you know the governor.
Governor Roosevelt?
Joseph. What have you done now?
I'm certain when you hear my explanation.
Thanks, Miss Larkin, bringing your daughter by my office. I already have a thorough grasp of the situation. Graphic illustrations included. Bully is the expression I usually employ to bestow approval. But in your case, I simply mean bully. And is this the boy of whom you spoke? How are you, son? I'm told we once shared a carriage ride.
This is my girlfriend.
Well, Joseph, don't just stand there letting those children sing. Endlessly. Give them the good news.
What good news?
That you've come to your senses and rolled back prices. Unless, of course, you'd like to invite a full state senate investigation into your employment practices.
You wouldn't.
After the pressure you wielded to keep me from office, I'd do it with a smile. Come on, Joseph. There's only one thing worse than a hard heart. And that's a soft head. And think of all the happiness you'd bring those children. He doesn't do happiness, does he?
Mr. Kelly, if I may speak to you alone.
Keep your eyes on the stars, feet on the ground. You can do this.
I cannot put the price back to where it was. I'm sorry I can't. There are other considerations.
I get it. You need to save face in front of all these folks. I'm young, I'm stupid.
Thank you for understanding.
But I got constituents with a legitimate gripe.
What if I reduce the raise by half and get the others to do the same? It's a compromise we can all live with.
But you eat our losses. From now on, every paper that a newsie doesn't sell, you buy back full price.
That's never been on the table. What's to stop newsies from taking hundreds of papers they can't sell? My costs will explode.
Ain't no newsie gonna break his back hauling around papers he can't sell. But if he can take a few more, he might sell it with no risk, and your circulation will begin to grow! It's a compromise we can all live with.
That's not a bad head you've got for the shoulders.
What? Deal?
That's disgusting.
It's just business.
And the days we do.
Each generation must, at the height of its power, step aside and invite the young to share the day. You have laid claim to our world, and I believe the future, in your hands, will be bright and prosperous. And your drawing son brought another matter to bear. Officers, if you please.
Hey, look at you! It's Crunchy!
These drawings, you made an eloquent argument for shutting down the refuge. Be assured that Mr. Snatter's abuses will be fully investigated. Officers, take him away.
Oh, please, Your Highness, may I do the honors?
You've got to be joking!
And you'll be laughing all the way to Japan,
little man!
Thank you, Governor. I can't help it. If one of your drawings convinced the Governor to shut down the refuge, what might a daily political cartoon do to expose the dealings in our own government backrooms? What do you say, Teddy? Care to have this young man's artistry shine a light behind your closed doors?
Don't sweat it, Gov. With the strike settled, I should probably be hitting the road.
Don't you ever get tired of singing that same old tune? What Santa Fe got the New York Gate? Sandstorms?
Better yet. What's New York got but Santa Fe?
New York's got us. And we're family.
Didn't I hear something about a strike being settled?
Thanks for the newsies. Why not boys these days they're gonna sell themselves?
Come along, Governor, and show me the back seat I've been hearing so much about!
Don't just stand there. You've got a union to run. Besides, didn't someone just offer you a pretty exciting job?
Would me work for your father?
You already work for my father.
Oh yeah.
And you've got one more ace up your sleeve.
And what's that?
Me. Wherever you go, I'm there, right by your side.
For sure?
For sure.
Don't take much to be a dreamer. All you do is close your eyes. It's a made-up world is all you'll ever see. Now my eyes.